Work for yourself. We're here waiting for you. Call us today at 623-5559 to set up your no-pressure, free consultation to see if we're the right fit for you.
Now this news on Wisconsin Radio Network, I'm Raymond Newpert. Attorney General Josh Call says tens of millions of dollars is being left on the table in lawsuit settlements while he and the Joint Finance Committee continue to spar over how to actually settle those settlements. Josh Call says if the stalemate continues, that at-risk figure could grow to hundreds of millions of dollars. Some Madison residents are concerned about plans to base new F-35 jets at Truax Field. Chamber of Commerce President Zach Brandon tells WIBA not all of them will be impacted by noise.
Most likely there's a large number of people who in our community are fighting against what they term the military-industrial complex, and they're using sound, even though they're not impacted, as the reason.
The Air Force is holding an open house on Thursday. And Janesville residents will be seeing an $8 a year rise in their water bill. That's so that the city can avoid paying interest while replacing aging water mains. This is Wisconsin Radio Network.
Hey, Janet, I'm going to have to miss that big meeting today. I'm in the ER.
They think it was a grizzly bear.
Hi, honey, it's Mom. We're not going to be able to make it. Freak snowstorm in Vegas of all places.
Bingo!
It's okay. Send us a video of your graduation.
Hi, just got a call. One of my patients has gone into labor. Could you ask her to hold on a teeny tiny while longer?
Dad, your 100th birthday is a big deal. But I've been kidnapped by a flying saucer. My gosh, it does sound just like a slot machine.
Problem gamblers miss a lot of important real-life events. Get back in the real game, the game of life. If you or someone you know has a gambling problem, we can help. Call 1-800-GAMBLE-5. That's 1-800-GAMBLE-5. Text us at 850-888-HOPE or visit wi-problemgamblers.org. Gamble responsibly, and everyone's a winner. A message from the Wisconsin Lottery.
Are you tired of getting hit with bowling balls every time you turn your water on due to the fact that it's so hard? Give us a call over at Schaefer's Soft Water in Watertown. We are a family-owned and operated business for over 60 years. We service and install and repair all major brands of water treatment equipment, both residential and commercial. So give us a call at Schaefer's Soft Water in Watertown at 920-261-3908 or 1-800-633-7440.
Oh, look, home isn't just where the heart is. It's where you can still hear years of dinner table talks and the floorboards creak in all the right places. At BDCH Hillside Home Care and Hospice, we understand what your home means to you. With personalized care from dedicated, specially trained nurses, therapists, and home health aides, you get the level of care you need delivered where you're most comfortable, your home. To learn more, call 920-887-4050 today.
There are lots of soft and fuzzy friends at the Dodge County Humane Society looking for forever homes. Check out the Pet of the Week at DailyDodge.com.
Here is a look at your weatherology forecast. For this afternoon, we'll see a good chance of scattered thunderstorms across the area, otherwise staying mostly cloudy with a high into the mid-70s. And then for later on tonight, scattered thunderstorms are likely with a low of 61. For Thursday, we'll see a chance of scattered storms, otherwise mostly cloudy with a high into the mid-70s. And then we'll stay partly sunny on Friday with a high of 71 degrees. I'm Nick Carlisle on your hometown station, AM 1430 WBEV. Right now it's 78.
1236 from AM 1430 WBEV, streaming online at dailydodge.com. It is time now for today's community comment. Here's your host, Craig Warmbold.
Well, thank you very much and good afternoon. Welcome to Community Comment. We are video streaming live on Daily Dodge under the video tab today for those of you out there on AM 1430 WBEV with some access to a internet connection. You can tune in live right now again under the video tab or check back here later after the program and you'll find the video up there as well. We have our guests here in the studio today are with Wisconsin Voices for Recovery. We want to welcome Geschke. She is the program coordinator for Wisconsin Voices for Recovery. And Nadine Miskovich is an advisory council member with Wisconsin Voices for Recovery and also the vice president of operations for Rise Together. Thank you guys very much for joining me on the program today.
Thanks for having us.
We are here to talk about an event that's coming up this Saturday at the Capitol. Why don't you tell us about it, Jesse?
So we are going to be hosting the statewide recovery rally at the Capitol from 11 to 3 on the State Street side. We do this annually. This will be our sixth annual recovery rally.
Excellent. Very good. So what do we mean by recovery rally?
So our recovery rally is a time and place for people from all across Wisconsin to come together at the Capitol and celebrate recovery, recovery in Wisconsin. So it can be recovery from any substances, mental health illness as well. And we bring in speakers from across the nation to come in and engage with our crowd. We also have a number of activities planned to include Narcan training. We have a kids area. We have Elevate from the Jackson area coming in to do a share your story section. Just a packed, filled day.
Excellent. Well, we'll talk a little bit more about that in a little bit more depth in just a minute. But first, can you tell us a little bit about Wisconsin Voices for Recovery?
Sure. So Wisconsin Voices for Recovery is a statewide organization. And what we do is bring about change to eliminate stigma. We coordinate efforts around the state to bring other RCOs, recovery community organizations, together to host events in their own organizations, their own towns, their communities. And so we help to do that. We host Narcan trainings. We host message trainings. And the other side of Wisconsin Voices is our ED2 recovery grant, so our emergency to recovery grant that we have. And so we go into emergency departments across the state and provide peer-to-peer contact with those who have survived an opioid overdose. And then this grant cycle will also be branching out to the, you know, community at large, so individuals who maybe have been arrested or you know, at a therapy treatment center that need help, just anyone on the street, such like that.
Excellent. So Nadine, you are an advisory council member of Wisconsin Voices for Recovery. You're also the vice president of operations for Rise Together. What's Rise Together?
Rise Together is a national nonprofit organization that primarily focuses on preventing addiction in adolescents and supporting positive mental health. We got started almost 6 years ago. We'll actually be celebrating 6 years tomorrow since the inception of the organization. But for us, we've been able to not only travel the state and also the nation, but get in front of over 175,000 young people over the last few years. In fact, we have the opportunity to get in front of Horicon School District on Friday and also West Bend, so really looking forward to that. But for us, being able to focus primarily on adolescents, really looking at addiction as a whole, we see that the best way to get ahead of the epidemic that we've been facing is through prevention. And so we often hear that prevention is key, and that is where we primarily focus. And that's for us as an organization. But for me, as an individual and as a person in long-term recovery, that is one of the reasons why I sit on the board or the advisory council for Wisconsin Voices for Recovery, being able to provide a youthful voice, not only bringing the voice of all the young people that I serve, bringing their voices to the table, but also mine as an individual in recovery and helping to lead change throughout the state of Wisconsin.
So if I understand this correctly, you've got kind of a educational component to your organization, Rise Together, Voices for Recovery. You guys, it sounds like, are there really in the times that may be needed most for some. Mm-hmm. You said emergency rooms specifically,
right,
at some. What is that like?
It's awesome. So yeah, we do the education, but also prevention side as well, with the stigma reduction. But we, we go into the emergency department. So we have a crew of peers that about 186 of them now, I think, that are employed through our nonprofit agencies that have been re-granted the grant.
Wow.
So they go in. We have 12 organizations that have these peers, and they go into the emergency departments. They meet with that person, after they've survived, and they walk them, through recovery. Wow. It's amazing.
And they tell them what their options are.
Yeah, they will. And they help them at their own pace. That's what recovery coaching or peer support specialists are about. And they just give them options and walk them in their journey of recovery.
Mm-hmm. And just to add on to what Jessica was saying, especially as a former opioid user, substance user, being able to know that, especially in that high-risk situation, knowing that there is support there with you right there when you need it, someone that's showing up that is not shaming you or blaming you or forcing you to change, but letting you know that, hey, like, recovery is possible, that there's other options out there, and for them to show up there in such a vulnerable state and be able to provide that support and resources right there on hand has been so crucial in saving lives and watching people that have been affected by the addiction over the last several years now.
Two and a half years now
that mm-hmm. you've gotten that grant or that you've yep. been together as an organization. What's the name of that grant again?
It came down from the state. It's called mm-hmm. 82 Recovery.
Okay.
But yep, it came down from feds to the state and then was re-granted.
And that allows you to basically do this, to get into emergency rooms and try to get people right when they need you most.
Yes.
Wow. With Rise Together, you're going into those classrooms, Horicon, West Bend, you said. What is it you're telling these kids?
So we really focus on a message of hope and recovery. And so we educate through storytelling by sharing some of our own personal lived experiences of things that we've gone through or some of the trauma that we've experienced or some of the challenges that we've faced. But really igniting a conversation of letting students, like, educating and really empowering them to not only share their own story but speak their own truth, to really break the silence around these volatile issues that our communities are facing, because it really goes so much further than addiction. I mean, we're looking at suicide and bullying and self-harm and some of these other really heavy issues that we know our young people are facing today. And so how can we provide better support and also empower them to be the change makers in their own community?
This is kind of growing out of this opioid crisis, I think, that it's being called. That's been just increasing in momentum in recent years and really over the better part of a decade or more here in Wisconsin and around the country. Are you getting a feeling that we're starting to put the right pieces into place to be able to address this comfortably?
One of the things that I would like to say is I think that Wisconsin has definitely been on the forefront. I think we've made huge, drastic changes over the last 5 years, and one of them being by breaking the silence around the issues that we've been facing. But one of the biggest things, and I know we can talk about it as we go into the recovery rally, but September is National Recovery Month. And we often focus and look at so much of, like, the heaviness and the deaths and the lives that are lost. And while we should definitely honor them and, you know, celebrate those lives, what we often don't get to talk about or hear about are all of the lives or people that are living in recovery today. Letting people know that recovery is possible, that there's people out there who are living a sober lifestyle, and being able to promote that, celebrate it, and share it is when we are able to come together on the Capitol steps in Madison to let people know that, hey, like, we know that there's an issue and there's thousands of people dying all the time due to opioids, and not just opioids. We look at addiction as a whole, alcoholism, you know, any other substance that people are using. Yes, it's really bad, but there's also a flip side to it, and that's where I think the recovery rally comes in. And what's so exciting is to see how people are celebrating recovery as well.
And this is on the Capitol this Saturday, mm-hmm. The State Street side, you said.
State Street side.
It is a rally. You're essentially hoping people come from all corners. Yep. And is it to celebrate recovery?
It is, yeah. We'll be celebrating recovery resources. We have 19 tables that will be filled with individuals from all over the state who are coming together to showcase their I'm not trying to say anything.
So the options and support that they have available.
Organizations, excuse me.
Sure. And what did you say? There's like 60, or how many did you say are coming?
So we have 19 tables and they're half tables. So about 40 organizations 40. That will be there to support. So a couple years ago, we were there. I've been involved with the Recovery Rally long before I became an employee of Wisconsin Voices. And you know, we did have an individual who came up from the farmer's market who was in withdrawal, and he came up and he just said, I didn't even know this was going on, but I'm here and I, you know, I would like some help. You know, what can I do? Where can I go? And the support that came around this gentleman, it was just amazing. And that is what this, you know, this is about. That's what this rally is about, is finding resources, getting people to where they need to go. We have family members that come to this rally, people who have lost someone that come to the rally. It's just, yeah, a great opportunity to come together and celebrate life and celebrate, you know, recovery, everything all about recovery.
Yeah, and even to look at, this is what, the sixth year. Rally is going on, and to know that there's 40 different resources available across the state, and that's not even all of them.
No.
But all of the people that are showing up and celebrating and supporting. I mean, when we started this 6 years ago, or when they had their first rally, there was not as many.
No.
And so to see, like, the progression on how, you know, we've been able to eliminate stigma and break the silence has been beautiful.
Mm-hmm. Well, what are some of the resources that are available? Is there somewhere you could direct, maybe if a listener right now is in need of some of those resources, what would you recommend if they were to ask you that?
Sure. I mean, Wisconsin, like Nadine had said, we've come a long way. So we have the 211 option now here in Wisconsin, which is amazing. So people can dial into 211, and you can find that on your website, just clicking in 211, and all resources of all kinds. So you can find inpatient, outpatient, you can find AA, NA, any type of support group that you want, that's all right there. And we also have Wiz Hope is another organization in the Milwaukee, Waukesha area. They have a website, and it's got a ton of information on there where you can plug in. It's got a map, like I'm in Dodge County, and I want to know where I can go for outpatient help, and maybe I want medicated-assisted treatment. And you can just click on the map, and it will show you where, you know, where you can go. So, and 211 also has a phone number that you can call and talk with somebody live, and they will help direct you to where you need to go.
You said, Nadine, that you've seen, and maybe I don't want to misquote you, that you've kind of seen the stigma lifted a little bit in recent years. Is that the case? Are you starting to see more people being sympathetic and understanding this plight that addicts are facing?
I do. I have certainly seen a difference since, you know, really over the last 5 years, more specifically since I've been more engaged in the conversation. And what I see or what I have seen and what I think is that for us as individuals who have dealt with the disease of addiction or have been dealt with a family member, being able to really speak out about that and share our stories, I've been able to see our community come together and really build compassion and empathy for those who are suffering and struggling, understanding that addiction is a disease. It's not a choice. It's not something that anybody ever wants. It's not something that you ever plan to do. But I believe that through the storytelling and through the compassion that we've been able to express, we've been able to really build better connections and better relationships, which I've seen our communities come together stronger than ever over this conversation because of that.
Our guests are with Wisconsin Voices for Recovery. Jessica Geschke is the program coordinator. Nadine Miskovich is an advisory council member. She's also with Rise Together. Their rally at the state capitol is this Saturday, 11 a.m. to 3 p.m. It's on the State Street side, and the public is invited and encouraged to attend. We do have to take a break real quick. We'll be back in just a few minutes.
Columbus Community Hospital serves those from Columbus to Rio, Beaver Dam, Sun Prairie, and more. Our name needs to convey who we are and who we serve. Therefore, as of October 1st, Columbus Community Hospital and Prairie Ridge Health Clinic will be changing its name to Prairie Ridge Health. The only change is our name. We have not been purchased. We have not merged. There are no changes in the insurances we accept and no changes in jobs. You will still receive the same high-quality, personal, compassionate care you have come to know and expect. The only change is our name. Prairie Ridge Health, inspired by you.
Farmers, are you worried that the current economic farming cycle will put you in a financial crisis or force restructuring? With decades of farm and ag knowledge and experience, Stan Jones Auction and Realty in Watertown can help you liquidate farm machinery, real estate, all or part of your assets. Stan can provide the latest cutting-edge, specialized, targeted marketing to help you make that transition. Contact Stan Jones for available opportunities to help you. Call 920-261-6820. On the web, jonesauctionservice.com. That's jonesauctionservice.com.
Westwood One presents NFL 100, remembering a century of excellence in pro football, sponsored by Prevagen. Prevagen is the most recommended memory support brand by pharmacists. Perhaps the toughest decision the NFL ever had to make was after the September 11th terrorist attacks in 2001. Weighing the balance between a nation's need to mourn and the disruption of American life, Commissioner Paul Tagliabue chose to cancel all games the following week. Giants defensive end Michael Strahan got a firsthand look at the devastation in New York City.
We are not heroes. The people who are over there pulling people out, those are heroes. We're guys who come out and just are very lucky to do what we do for a living. And those are the guys who put their lives on the line. That's a hero.
When the football heroes did return to the field a week later, security was heightened and patriotic fans bonded together as America began the long healing process. Stay with Westwood One all season long as we celebrate the 100th season of the National Football League.
Napa Know How. At Napa, save up to $10 on a pair of Rain-X Latitude wiper blades, plus get Rain-X glass cleaner for free. It's a deal so good, you gotta see it to believe it. That's a vision joke. And with up to $10 off Rain-X Latitude wipers plus free Rain-X glass cleaner, you'll be able to see almost everything. Quality parts, helpful people. That's Napa Know How.
Napa Know How.
At participating Napa Auto Parts stores, while supplies last. Offer ends 9/30/19.
Hi, my name's Christina Stumble, and I own Farm Girl Flowers in San Francisco. With my Spark Cash Card from Capital One, I earn unlimited 2% cash back on all my business purchases. Last year, I redeemed $115,000 in cash back. Yeah, $115,000. And that doubled our digital marketing budget for the summer. Thanks to my Spark Card, we had our best summer yet. Imagine what the Spark Card from Capital One could do for your business. What's in your wallet?
Real Capital One customers pay for real stories.
Tune in to 95X or AM 1430 WBEV for coverage of the upcoming Green and Gold game. And listen for the Columbus Family Dental Mystery Player of the Game. Then listen to the WBEV Morning Show the following business day and be the correct number caller when we ask, who was the Columbus Family Dental Mystery Player of the Game? Get it right, and you'll win a Sonicare Power Toothbrush. Plus, you'll be entered into the grand prize drawing for an end-of-the-season mystery prize.
Local sports, exciting interviews, special events, and cooking demonstrations are all on DailyDodge.com. Fast forward to the video page, sponsored by Kramer Wisconsin Cheese.
12:55 from AM 1430 WBEV Beaver Dam. Time for new tires. Pull into the Quick Lane service at Countryside Ford in Columbus. No appointment necessary. Get the price match guarantee. Countryside Ford, 330 Transit Road, Columbus. Time for more of today's community comment. Here again is your host, Craig Warmbold.
Well, thank you very much. And our guests are with Wisconsin Voices for Recovery. Nadine Miskovich is an advisory council member, and Jesse Geschke is the program coordinator. Nadine is also the vice president of operations for Rise Together. We're talking about a rally at the Capitol. There's a recovery rally this Saturday from 11 a.m. until 3 p.m. on the State Street side of the Capitol. There's going to be a number of resources available for those that are dealing with addiction, maybe perhaps looking to get answers for the first time, or even, look into information for somebody else. That there's a, as I said, a number of speakers that are going to be at the event. Tell us what, how the afternoon will, or that 4 hours will unfold if folks arrive at 11 a.m. on Saturday. What can they expect?
Sure. So we will start off with the welcome and kickoff at 11. And then we'll have some resource tables. We'll open with music performed by Lee Turner. And then we will have, at 11:35, we'll have what to expect from the rally. We'll just kind of briefly talk about the rally and what's going on and why we rally. And then we have a shoe drive this year.
Cool.
So we're going to have Lee Turner's wife, Tiffany Turner, who runs shoe drives all across the nation as well as other countries. So she'll be talking about the shoe drive. And then we have the Ho-Chunk Native Drumming Circle at 11:40. And then we have free pizza lunch. And the resource fair will open up again.
Did you say free pizza?
I sure did.
Awesome.
It's free pizza, people. At 12:05, we have the governor's proclamation. So that will be presented. And then at 12:10, we have the Wisconsin Voices Recovery Award that we will be handing out. So we had four organizations that were nominated this year, and we put it out on a SurveyMonkey, and the state, everyone from the state, the community voted. So we have a winner. I'm really excited about that. And then we have the resource fair opening back up again with some DJ music. And then at 12:20, we have our featured speaker, Mr. Ryan Hampton. And so he will be speaking for about a half hour. And then we have our next speaker, which will be Monte Ball.
Oh.
Yes, Monte Ball is coming in. And then we have a little musical break, and then we'll be starting with some local speakers. So we have Martine Tate coming in to speak and sharing a mother's perspective of how the addiction has affected her. And then we have Matthew, I will probably kill this last name, Jebelunski, and he will be talking about recovery through jail. And then we have a musical break, and then we have Mr. Kellen Geschke speaking, addiction through a child's eyes. And then we have Susie Austin speaking, and she will be talking about then and now and how recovery works. I'm really excited about Susie speaking as well, because she spoke at our very first recovery rally. And so she'll be speaking again now, and she just celebrated 21 years in recovery.
Wow.
So, yeah. Mm-hmm. And then at 2 o'clock, we have our next featured speaker, Lee Turner. And then Lee and his wife, Tiffany, will be closing out the recovery rally with a closing song. I have not told anyone what that song will be yet, but it's going to be amazing. And then we will do our normal group picture on the stairs that we do every year that kind of closes our recovery rally. So this is the first year ever that we've had three huge name speakers come in. And the reason we could do that is because of our sponsorships. We have a ton of amazing sponsors this year for the rally. We have ATTC in Madison that sponsored our main speakers, Ryan, Monte, and Lee. And then we have Telerium that came forward with a sponsorship, CMS, Just Listen, the Department of Health and Human Services, Rise Together, and Stop Heroin Now, and then Wiz Hope. So, again, thank you to all of our sponsors, because without them, we would never have been able to pull off this rally. So, yeah, we're really excited. You want to know more about our speakers, we can talk about that.
I do. I'd like to look a little bit more in-depth at that. But first, just kind of a comment. It does really kind of take collaboration and the community coming mm-hmm. together to be able to pull something like this off, I would imagine.
Oh, yes. Yes, very much so. Tons of emails have gone out and, asking people if they wanted to participate. And the response from everyone from around the state has just been so overwhelming. It takes a lot to pull off a rally like this. And the volunteers that we have, people, I had, I think, 6 or 7 people that I do not even know email me and say, hey, like, I'm from Sheboygan. I'm from, Ashland. I'm from so-and-so, and I'm just coming to the rally. Is there something I can help with? Oh, so wow. I'm putting them to work.
Mm-hmm. Are there things people can help with? Do you need volunteers for anything?
I think we're set with volunteers, but I just want people to come. Just come and enjoy yourself. This year we did a little bit different setup. The last couple of years, we haven't really had a staging area and seating area per se to listen to our speakers. And, you know, and I get it. There's a lot of standing only room and time up there because we are on the top of the Capitol right as you would walk into the Capitol building. And that's where we're located. And so we're going to be putting up 35 to 40 chairs so people can sit. You can enjoy your free pizza. And we also have granola, and we'll have some water and some apples and stuff like that. So, Oh, and we have popcorn. So this is new also this year. Rally people. This has never been heard of yet. I didn't even announce this. So we have a popcorn vendor who will be down State Street in the farmer's market along the sidewalk. And when you arrive at the rally, you will get a ticket to go down and get one free bag of gourmet popcorn on Wisconsin Voices for Recovery. So
I'm here for that.
Woo! Yeah. I know. If you come for anything, just come for the free popcorn. Yeah. But yeah, it's going to be really great. So I'm really excited about that.
Once again, this is on the steps of the Capitol, the State Street side this Saturday from 11 a.m. to 3 p.m. Are you, with this location, presumably trying to send a message to lawmakers about the plight of where we're at and you know, hope to keep this top of mind, if you will?
I mean, yeah. I don't know if it's necessarily sending a message, but we always want our lawmakers to know that we are alive and well and that we are here and we're not leaving. We want bills passed, right? There's a couple things out there on the docket. And that's me personally talking. That's not me, Wisconsin Voices, talking, because I can't do that. So, of course, like, there's a reason that we do this at the Capitol, and not just for that either, but just because Wisconsin Capitol is home, right? If you think about Wisconsin, you see our Capitol, and that is our home. And I believe that people in recovery and people who love someone in recovery deserve to be home just as much as anyone else. And it's about breaking stigma. And so that's why we're there, because we deserve to be there too, just as much as anyone else.
Wow. And you're the MC for the afternoon, Nadine. Quite a slate of speakers that you'll be introducing throughout the course of the afternoon.
Yes, absolutely. And I am honored, not only honored to be the first female MC of the event, but honored to introduce these amazing speakers that we're bringing in this year.
Monte Ball, where does he fit into this message, this situation that we are in here?
So Monte Ball was a former running back for the Badgers. I am not a football person, but that is what he is. It was, right? Running back. And also, I believe he was a Broncos player.
Okay. A little time in the NFL, sure.
Yes. But he's in recovery. And so we reached out to him. He said, oh, my gosh, yes. Like, Madison is his hometown, and so he would love to come and speak. And so he's coming in. He's coming in and Friday, and he'll be in town. And yeah, he was just overjoyed to be able to come in and share a message of, hope and inspiration. And I also wanted to mention the recovery rally this year. Our motto is that all pathways to recovery are acceptable. I'm paraphrasing right now, but and so I wanted to stress that you know, everyone's pathway to recovery is their own. And so that's why we chose our speakers, Ryan, Monte, and Lee, because every single one of those individuals started someplace. And with Monte starting in the NFL and, you know, having an addiction, and look at where he is today. And so he overcame barrier after barrier. Ryan Hampton, he is just simply amazing. I cannot say enough about Ryan Hampton and what he's done for myself personally and my family. But Ryan, he used to work at the White House, and he was addicted to opiates while he was working in the White House. And so, again, like, just to resonate that and where he is today and everything he is doing for our country. And Lee Turner, I absolutely love him. I've never met him personally, but he used to go to my high school in Horicon. Oh, wow. He's from Horicon. And so he is a member of the Darius Rucker band, and so he just aspires, you know, to be able to share his message with people through music, and I just love him. And so again, like, they all come to one place, this Capitol, on Saturday to share their message of hope and inspiration through all walks of life. They all got here their own way, and that's what it's about. And even our local speakers as well.
When we talk about stigma, and we do hear about some of those names that may have more selection to them, like Monte Ball and mm-hmm. member of Darius Rucker's band and things like that. That seems like the type of thing that does go a long way to lift the stigma of what yes. we're talking about, when people realize that these are people that we had known and loved in a kind of setting, and then we see those struggles may not be very different than our own. Mm-hmm. I imagine that goes a long way.
Yeah, I think it for sure. And that's, you know, that's one of the reasons that when we go to book people, we of course we want that, but we also want the homegrown Wisconsin people. Mm-hmm. And then when we you know, every year we've sat back and thought about, okay, who's going to MC this event, and this, again, like Nadine said, is the first year we've had a woman do it. I don't know why every year we've had a male. But we have three heavy male speakers that are going to bring such, you know, greatness to this event. So we said we need a female MC. And when you're talking about you know, celebrity, right, Nadine is that person. Not, I don't want to say you're a celebrity, right? But you are. I mean, in Wisconsin. And so we without a doubt chose Nadine for that purpose, because this woman has done so much in the short 7 years that I have known her, in her career. Like, I'm blown away by everything that she has been able to accomplish. I knew her within 3 months of her getting sober, working with Rise Together, and watching her excel and the things that she's been able to do. And she is such a role model for youth. So it was a no-brainer for us to say she needs to do this and be the voice, right, at that microphone on Saturday. And so that's why we have this lineup. And again, if you're struggling out there, if you just need some motivation, come on Saturday, because you will not be disappointed.
Nadine, you've been a speaker at a few of these events, it seems like.
Mm-hmm. I have.
Can you share, however briefly you wish, your story with us? What is it? You have a bit of a background in this. What do you tell people at these events?
I do. So to let everyone know who is listening or watching, I'm actually a Beaver Dam native. So I grew up, born and raised right here in Beaver Dam, Wisconsin. And, you know, when we look at the conversation around addiction, and even, you know, when we talk about influencers or celebrities or, you know, people, really, addiction doesn't discriminate. It doesn't matter where you come from, what type of work you do, you know, what you look like, what you sound like. None of that matters, because it doesn't. It doesn't discriminate. And for me, growing up here in Beaver Dam, while this was a beautiful community to grow up in, unfortunately, you know, we look at America as a whole, and there's 1 in 3 households today being affected by the addiction crisis. 1 in 3. Mm-hmm. And my home was one of them. And growing up, watching family members struggle, different, you know, my parents struggle, really stems back to breaking the silence, you know, for us not really understanding really what the disease of addiction looks like, not really understanding what it looks like to ask for help. The resources and support have been lacking, not here just in this community, but in all communities. We've been able to partner with over 150 different schools across the state. We've worked in over 53 different counties, and let me tell you that there is no one county that's better than the other. There's so many resources that are needed yet, and to see, fortunately enough for me, I was able to receive support at the age of 19, going on 20. I had my sister walk into my life at that time, and she offered me the support that I needed, you know, and I detoxed in her basement, and it was certainly not ideal, and it was not something that I would ever recommend to anybody else that's struggling. But unfortunately, there were no other resources or options available to me at that time. And you know, to be able to be loved and supported and have somebody walk through that journey with me, similar to what recovery coaches or peer support looks like, it helped me get to this place today and let me know that, you know, even though I've made many mistakes in my life, I no longer believe that I am one, you know, and to know that I matter and that I am here for a reason and that I am worthy and that my story matters and that my voice matters. And so I have continued to speak out and become an influencer or celebrity, as Jess would say.
I'm not her friend.
But I am. I'm so fortunate to be given this platform and this opportunity to not only let others know that recovery is possible, but that there's hope. You know, to spread light on such a dark topic is so necessary. And I'm just fortunate enough to be able to do that.
You can attest that there is life beyond detox. Mm-hmm.
There is a
terrible situation to go through.
Mm-hmm.
But there is light at the other end of the tunnel.
There sure is.
Ryan Hampton is another speaker of a certain celebrity status. He's known nationally as part of this addiction fight. Elaborate a little bit more on Ryan Hampton. And this was the gentleman that you said just a few moments ago worked in the White House.
Mm-hmm.
I imagine he tours the country telling his story. It's a big deal that you've got him in Madison for this event.
It is huge. Yeah, so Ryan Hampton wrote a book. He wrote a book. He's also...
It's called The American Fix.
American Fix, mm-hmm. yes. And he's also the founder of The Voices Project.
Okay.
I don't know, you know, to me, Ryan's just Ryan. Someone who saved my son's life. That's Ryan to me. Ryan's a lot of things, I guess, to a lot of people. He's a motivational speaker, and he goes around the country, and he's an activist. He wants change. He talks to, you know, people in the White House, Big Pharma. He's a motivator. He's amazing. I had the privilege to be a part of some stuff out in Vegas with him and his group. And it was life-changing for me with Mobilized Recovery. But my first, I guess, encounter with Ryan was back in about a year and a half ago when my son wrote a story that we submitted to the Voices Project. And Ryan picked it up and read it and was so touched by it. And then he put it on his webpage. And it ended up getting... thousands and thousands and thousands of hits nationwide. And he reached out to my kid and told him that it's okay, you know, it's okay to feel the way you feel and all the stuff you've gone through, and that he was there if he ever needed it. And my son was just blown away by the fact that this giant of an activist reached out to him. And so Kellen and Ryan have a very special relationship, and Kellen absolutely adores him. And every time he comes to Wisconsin, he's right next to Ryan. And so Kellen is so excited for Friday because Ryan's going to be speaking with Rise in the schools. And Kellen is going to be right there next to Ryan. So Ryan is just an amazing human being.
Mm-hmm. I know some people in the community have had an opportunity to hear Kellen's story. I know I've heard it a couple times. Mm-hmm. Beaver Dam Community Theater had done a spotlight on addiction, and
all
we were all on that panel. And it what an amazing story he told at that time. He's going to be one of the speakers on Saturday. Is this something that he's wanting to do? This seems like it's developed into quite a passion for him, and it's such a sensitive, mm-hmm. you know, topic that's so close to him.
Yeah, I mean, he wants to be a professional basketball player when he grows up, after he goes to college to become a therapist. So,
big dreams.
Big dreams, yeah. Yes. Like he loves to share his story, well, his uncle's story of recovery. You know, for a long time it was his uncle's story of addiction, active use, and how sad he was. But now he has another chapter to write, and he's very, very excited to share how amazingly well his uncle is doing in recovery. And for me to be able to see that and to see the relationship and the bond that my brother and my son have again is simply wonderful. And so for Kellen to be able to share that and to talk to other kids who may be going through it or have parents who are using – He just wants those people to know that recovery is possible. And even though you might not think it is, like, he's been there, and he just never stopped hoping and praying. And, you know, God saw my brother through, and he's hopeful that others can too.
It wasn't always easy.
No.
But extremely powerful. I mean, mm-hmm. if you look at hearing a young person's voice, someone that's been personally impacted or affected, and we look at our next generation today, there's so many students yes. and young people that are standing up. You know, when we go into schools and we ask a question, simply we usually ask a few questions, like, do you think drugs and alcohol are a problem in your community? Do you think that they're a problem in your school? You know, sure, we get 75% to 85% of the students raising their hands. But we also have asked questions like, do you know someone that has lost their life yeah. due to the disease of addiction? And to see the amount of young people that are standing up to that question. I was actively using in high school, and I still couldn't answer that question. Like, I wouldn't have been able to stand up because I didn't know anybody who had been so deeply impacted yet, you know, and gratefully so that I didn't. But to see people as young as 10, 11, 12, 13 years old, and how we've had young people stand up saying that they've lost their mom and their dad, mm-hmm. or they've lost both of their brothers, or their brother and sister. And it is heartbreaking. And so to see a young person, and as vulnerable as they may be, to see the strength, you know, to be able to speak their truth and let them know, sure, I have been deeply impacted, but I'm still here standing strong today with my family because we're in this together.
Yep.
Our guests today need you to go to the Capitol on Saturday, 11 a.m. to 3 p.m. They're going to have the Wisconsin Voices for Recovery statewide rally, again, on the Capitol steps, Stateside Street, with a number of speakers. There's going to be a number of resources that'll be available as well, some entertainment and food, all part of that event. We do have to take a break here. A quick note to our listeners on AM 1430 WBEV. We are video streaming live. Feel free to go to the video tab at dailydodge.com if you want to watch today's program. You can go to our Facebook page if you want to share today's program to your Facebook page. Or if you want to check it out after the show is all over. We'll take a break now and be back here in just a few minutes to wrap things up with Jesse Geschke and Nadine Moscovich.
Fill your workshop with big savings on a great selection of power tools from Menards. Tackle dozens of jobs with a Black & Decker 20-volt 4-tool combo kit with a 3/8-inch drill, circular and reciprocating saws, an LED work light, two batteries and charger, just $119. Save on Black & Decker power tools and more. Prices good through September 21st. Now during Menards' fall catalog sale.
Save big money at Menards.
The emergency department and urgent care at Columbus Community Hospital is staffed by Madison emergency physicians, board certified in emergency medicine, the same physicians who staff the ER at St. Mary's Hospital in Madison. Open 24/7, the recent recipients of the Guardian of Excellence Award. Columbus Community Hospital is here for you.
For the last 60 years, our marketing hasn't won many awards, but we've been consistently making great mattresses. And right now, if you buy a V7, V9, or V11 mattress set, you'll get a free adjustable base. Verlo, bad at marketing, great at mattresses.
Adjustable bases allow you to sleep in the best position for you for a good night's sleep. Elevate your whole sleeping experience. Ask how you can get a free adjustable base with the purchase of a V7, V9, or V11 mattress at Verlo in Fort Atkinson and Beaver Dam.
Surefire, be sure with Surefire.
I'm a new homeowner, and I've got a Lennox home comfort system from Surefire. Why did I go to Surefire? Simple. I grew up with one. Where did Dad get the idea of selecting the most efficient home comfort? He grew up with one too. Three generations, one great unit. Oh, and down the road, when my kids ask me what home comfort system to purchase, I'll simply say Lennox. Because while generations change, the quality of a Lennox won't.
Call Surefire today to take advantage of rebates up to $1,600, plus Focus on Energy rebates up to $250. Plus, Lennox has now offered some of the best financing options in the industry. Call Surefire today or check us out at SurefireInc.com.
Be sure with Surefire.
from the back streets of the Motor City to the front page of American music history. It's the Four Tops. Performing live September 14th, 7 p.m. at Ho-Chunk Gaming, Wisconsin Dells. Tickets are on sale now through Ticketmaster. Don't miss an American classic. The Four Tops, September 14th at Ho-Chunk Gaming, Wisconsin Dells. Experience the difference.
Must be 21 to attend the Four Tops concert and to enter the casino floor.
It's that time of year again for the 6th annual Beaver Dam Pepper Festival on Saturday, September 14th from 9 to 5. Apple pepper pancakes and sausage served all day. And yes, those tasty Beaver Dam pepper brats are back, along with pepper smoothies from Blue Zones and yummy toasted cheese served by Sage's School in Fox Lake. New this year, oh my God, Beaver Dam Pepper Beer, brewed at Beaver Dam's very own Ooga Brewing Company. Come get you some of that. Pie eating contest, and of course, Mr. Steve's Kid Show and Hillbilly Science Guy will have the kids howling. Is your chili the best? Back again, the Chili Cook-Off. Registration form at BeaverDamPepperFestival.com. The Swingin' Beaver Square Dance Group, Jeremiah Purdy and Elwood Lee and Mike Roddy will entertain all day. Join the fun and celebrate this crazy pepper at the 6th Annual Beaver Dam Pepper Festival on Saturday, September 14th. Held at and brought to you by Keller Real Estate Group and Park Village Shopping Center at the intersection of Highway 151 and 33. See you there.
At Landmark Credit Union, our checking options offer so much more, and we want you to choose your checking. It's back towards other purchases or earn some interest. What about even more interest? All of our options have no monthly fees, free online and mobile banking, and access to thousands of ATMs nationwide. To learn more, visit landmarkcu.com/yourchecking or stop in one of our 30 branch locations, including Beaver Dam, Fall River, Juneau, and Mayville. Landmark Credit Union, you're worth more here. Federally insured by NCUA.
See the latest local obituaries online at DailyDodge.com. Brought to you by Lidkey Motors.
23 minutes after 1 o'clock from AM 1430 WBEV. Time for more of today's community comment. Here again is your host, Craig Warmbold.
And our guests are with Wisconsin Voices for Recovery, Program Coordinator Jesse Geschke, and Nadine Moscovich is an advisory council member with Wisconsin Voices for Recovery, and also the vice president, did I get it right? Did I?
No, sorry.
And also the vice president of operations for Rise Together. They are in to talk about a recovery rally. It's at the Capitol this Saturday, 11 a.m. to 3 p.m. on the State Street side. There's going to be a number of speakers that are there, resource tables, food, entertainment, an opportunity to get together, to learn a little something, and to show support for those out there in the community that are going through this this very, very trying affliction right now in our communities. Among the speakers are local individuals that will be talking. Kellen Geschke, your son, is among those speakers. Martine Tate is from the Wisconsin area, and she will be speaking. Monte Ball, former Badger and NFL player, will be speaking at the event as well, along with Ryan Hampton, who we noted earlier is a nationally touring speaker who has gone from state to state over the years to talk about basically this entire situation and how it's been unfolding. And Nadine, I know that's something that is really caught your attention over the year, everything that Ryan has done.
Yeah, so I too fortunately had the opportunity to meet Ryan a few years ago now, I think back in 2016, when we were doing some work with young people in recovery. And Ryan Hampton, he used to work in the Bill Clinton administration. So when Jess was saying, he used to work in the White House, he did incredible work. And, unfortunately, addiction, took him over for a while there. But over the last few years, he's done some beautiful work. And it all really started by him traveling across the nation with one of his best friends, Garrett, and they were able to ignite a conversation in all of the communities that they went into by asking people to share their stories. And that looked like going into not only big communities, big cities, but also small towns, small rural communities, and looking at communities like Dayton, Ohio, for example, who has just been destroyed by the addiction crisis, and being able to go into those communities and ask people how have they been affected. needed. And that's really where the Voices Project was born, by getting individuals to go online and share their stories. And he's created this incredible community of hundreds of thousands of people, all people that have been affected by addiction. And a lot of them, or the majority of them, are parents that have unfortunately watched their children either, you know, unfortunately lose their life to addiction, or have been affected by it in some way or another. And so for him to be able to highlight those stories and to really put a face to a voice, if you will, and be able to showcase not only, you know, how this addiction crisis is destroying our communities, but also how the people are showing up and rebuilding their communities even after it being destroyed by it.
In a recovery rally is kind of a nod to that idea that there is light at the end of the tunnel, and mm-hmm. that recovery is possible.
Absolutely.
There is going to be discussion on Narcan training, as I understand it, at the rally. Exactly what are people going to be able to learn from that? Is there actual training going to be taking place? Are you going to be talking about training? What is that?
Sure. So we have two trainings that will take place right there on the Capitol lawn. The AIDS Resource Center of Wisconsin in the Madison location will be on hand. So Heidi's coming. She's a phenomenal. She will be there and will be doing two Narcan trainings, one at 11 to 11:30 and one from 1 till 1:30. So we will have a privacy tent set up, and we have about six boxes of Narcan to give out after the trainings are completed. So we're trying to do 30 in the first and 30 in the second. We did have a sign up on our web page for a while. People were signing up, so we were really excited about that. But if you didn't sign up, no worries. Just come to the rally and ask for the Narcan training, and we'll get you squared away. And we'll train as long as we have boxes of Narcan available.
And so, for those that are not familiar with Narcan, can you explain what it is?
Sure. So when an individual overdoses on opioids, Narcan can be administered and help to reverse the opioids that are on your brain, which when they're on your brain, it's suppressing the ability for your brain to tell you to breathe and to function. And so Narcan will come in and it'll sit on top of those receptors and kind of push the opioids off so that your brain can function and tell you to breathe again. And it's a life-saving, and everyone should carry Narcan. It's a very, you know, must-have, needed thing. Mm-hmm. Hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of thousands of lives have been saved by Narcan. And, everyone needs to have Narcan available for their use.
Used to be illegal, if I'm not mistaken. It wasn't something that was necessarily available to the general public.
Yeah, so you used to have to have a prescription that you would have to go fill at the at the pharmacy. You can now get it over the counter. We've come a long way with Narcan, but again, this is a stigma-induced, related, thing with this epidemic, right? Narcan, you shouldn't have to have even a prescription for Narcan, because if you're not addicted to opiates, Narcan's not going to do anything to you. You can accidentally inject yourself with Narcan and you're not going to have any adverse effects from it if you're not addicted to opiates, if you have no opiates in your system. So again, it just goes back to the stigma related to having an addiction, and it's sad.
Is it difficult to administer Narcan?
It is not difficult, no. And you'll learn that in the training, but no. So there's several forms of Narcan that can be administered. I would say that if you have the vial and the needle where you have to, draw it out, that's difficult, and it's very scary to do on someone, especially if that is a relative. But now they make them where you can just put it in someone's nose. And they also have an auto injector one where it can just be like an EpiPen. And it even tells you and pull off the red cap, place in thigh. It tells you exactly what to do. So it's very, very easy.
I don't need you to speak to the cost necessarily, but is it a reasonably priced type of thing?
No.
No.
So no, if you don't have insurance, Narcan will typically cost about $170 for two doses of Narcan. Insurances will cover it, but you'll have your copay, obviously. But the majority of individuals seeking Narcan, you know, sometimes they don't have insurance. So, and some insurances don't cover Narcan, again, with the stigma. So we, at Wisconsin Voices for Recovery, we have our grant, and our grant administrators at DHS are amazing, and they've allowed us to use some of our grant funds to purchase Narcan. And so we are doing the trainings and giving the Narcan away for free to the general public.
Oh, okay. Yep. So you won't be using actual Narcan for the training, will you?
No, I mean, so the trainings
some
are...
Some simulation type of thing.
But you will leave with a box of free Narcan in hand to take home and have on your person.
And how important is that to the friends, the family, or an individual who has perhaps not gone through recovery yet, and that's still something that may be off in the distance?
A dead person cannot recover.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So it's life-saving. I mean, I've heard stories of people who have had Narcan on them in Walmart because their son is addicted to opiates, and they went into the restroom at Walmart and noticed a female slumped over and didn't know what was wrong and realized, oh my gosh, this person is overdosed on opiates. They gave that individual Narcan and she lived, and she's in recovery today. So you never know when that person, you know, when that person's change will occur, and we aren't here to judge that. So give them Narcan, get them into recovery, and that could be their turning point. And who are you to judge? This is a really big touchy subject for me, so I'm going to stop with that.
And I imagine that is one of the things that helps to lift that stigma, which is one of the intents of the recovery rally at the Capitol this Saturday, 11 a.m. to 3 p.m., with a wide variety of speakers, including Monte Ball. There's also going to be Lee Turner, who is a member of Darius Rucker's band. He's from Hootie and the Blowfish, if I'm not mistaken.
Yes, he is.
I forgot that there was a Horicon gentleman that is in Darius Rucker's band.
That is Lee Turner.
Yeah, that's Lee Turner. And he's going to be performing as well.
Yeah, so him and his wife will be performing. So if you get to the rally, get there by 11, because he will be doing music, and he is amazing. So you don't want to miss his music during the resource fair that kicks off at 11.
There's also going to be a Faces of Addiction quilts. What is that about?
Yeah, so Bev Kelly Miller decided a few years ago, so she's been personally impacted by addiction. So unfortunately, her daughter lost her life to opioids about 5 years ago now, I believe. And since then, she had really tried to turn her pain into her power and try to go out and make a difference. And that resulted in her collecting all of the faces of those that have been affected by addiction, or individuals that have been affected by addiction throughout the state of Wisconsin. And so people have been able to submit their picture along with their story. And what she's done is she's put all of these pictures of individuals on quilts. And so she's had tons of volunteers come together and sew these huge, massive quilts. And she's going to be bringing four of them to the rally to showcase and highlight those that have been affected by addiction. And I believe she has, I think, over 700 faces on those quilts. And what's beautiful is not only is it highlighting those that have been affected by addiction, so there is different colors for different squares. And so those that are on the white squares are individuals who are living in recovery today. Then there are individuals who are on red squares, so those who are still struggling or suffering and are in active addiction. And then there are those on gray squares, and those individuals are people that are incarcerated due to their addiction. And then lastly, there are individuals on the black squares, and the black squares are those that we have lost, that have lost their life due to addiction. And to see so many faces, it is extremely powerful. I got to see them all up this last weekend event in Appleton, and she is just a beautifully powerful woman that has come together to really highlight not only, you know, that addiction is real, but also that we are real people, you know, that we could look at numbers all day, we could look at statistics all day, but to really put a face to those numbers, that we're human, you know, and that we're people first, and our addiction is just a small piece of that.
The excuse me, the Faces of Addiction Quilts will be one of the events that is taking place at the Recovery Rally on the Capitol this Saturday. There's a shoe drop as well. What's that about?
Yep. So Tiffany Turner, Lee's wife, will be there as well. I'm so excited that she's coming. So I have been kind of stalking Lee's Facebook page, and I started to notice that he was going to different countries with his wife, and they were doing a lot of service work, like in Africa and Honduras. And I was like, what is this all about? And so she works for or helps volunteer at an organization called Souls for Souls. And in learning more about it, they refurbish gently used shoes to help individuals in other countries, but also here in America as well, obtain employment. And they give away those shoes then to people who can't afford shoes. And so because she's coming with Lee to the rally, I decided, hey, like, let's do a shoe drive. So if you bring a gently used pair of shoes on Saturday to the Capitol, you will get a free Wisconsin Voices for Recovery t-shirt. So while supplies last, 1 to 10 pairs of shoes will get you a t-shirt, and then 11 to 20 pairs of shoes will get you a sweatshirt, I believe. So we just placed a huge, massive order of gear. Everyone loves our gear, and they want to wear our shirts and sweatshirts. So bring shoes to the shoe drive so we can present them to Tiffany and her team. That's amazing. She's amazing. She just does so much for other people.
Excellent. Again, the recovery rally on the square at the Capitol on the steps, State Street side, 11 a.m. to 3 p.m. This Saturday. Number of speakers, resources, et cetera. How's your brother doing?
He's doing really well.
Good.
Yeah, he just celebrated a year of sobriety on August 8th.
What?
Yep. And so I am so proud of him, and he's doing fantastic. He's working two jobs and keeping very busy and loving life.
How's Kellen doing?
Kellen's doing great. He's 13. Wow. So, he's an eighth grader at St. Stephen's in Oregon, and loves basketball and loves his family and his uncle. And yeah, he's doing really well.
Such an articulate young man and great speaker. I think I saw him when he was 11, if I'm not mistaken. Even at that young age, what a wonderful speaker. What a great asset to help assist those in looking for recovery and those in recovery. You must be a very proud mom.
I am super proud of him.
You're going to, again, have an opportunity to see him on Friday before all of this. He'll be speaking inside of school to, is it high school students at Horicon?
Yep, it'll be the high school students in Horicon, and then also we'll be over in West Bend.
In West Bend as well.
West Bend.
That's mm-hmm. wonderful. And the message has got to be a little different, I would think, when you're talking to high school students. How does that kind of change what it is you say to high school students versus what you might say at a larger rally like you do on Saturday?
I think Kellen's message, for Kellen in particular, we've been kind of working on what he wants to talk about, but his message at the schools are going to be about how he relates to those kids. I've felt this way, because Kellen has suffered from, depression, some sadness related to his uncle's overdose, and he's had some trauma experiences related to that, and so much to the point where we moved out of our house. He couldn't go into the living room. Just became a really big issue, and so I put the house on the market and we moved. And so he's going to talk about that, but also about overcoming those barriers and being able to still live, and be happy for his uncle, who's now in recovery. And I think at the Capitol, it's going to be a different message. He wants to talk more about those who have inspired him, because he's going to be surrounded by recovery giants at the Capitol. And so he wants to talk about, like, what that means for him. As a youth.
Again, this is all 11 a.m. to 3 p.m. this Saturday at the state capitol. Nadine, why do you think folks should make it a point to attend this rally, support those that may need to go through this process? Why should we mark this on our calendars?
So as I choke up just listening to Jess share about what Kellen's going to be speaking on, I think that that is one of the main reasons why we should show up, is for our next generation, to show up and to let others know that recovery is possible, that there is hope, you know, that there's hope still there, and to really let other people know that there's support, that you don't have to be ashamed, that you don't have to continue to hide in the darkness any longer, that you can come forth and ask for help. And I know asking for help can be one of the most difficult things that we do as humans, but to know that there's help there. And whether you show up on Saturday or, you know, if this is something that's been laying on your heart, you know, make sure that you reach out to us. Reach out to Wisconsin Voices or some of the other organizations that are going to be there. You know, this is such a great day to celebrate and to show up and to be present and to know that our communities are coming together. But I also want to remind you, too, that this is one day. That this doesn't just end after September 14th. You know, that we need to continue to show up day for our people, because there are people that are continuing to die every single day. And so how can we continue to highlight this conversation today, not only Saturday, not only during month, but what are we doing after that? And I think that that is just a highlight of, you know, being able to show up on Saturday, get involved in your community, get involved with some of the organizations that are going to be there. We're going to have amazing groups of people that are showing up, whether it's from treatment centers, recovery homes, or, you know, different organizations that are working in prevention or are working in treatment or providing recovery support services. Wherever they're from, there's help that is needed. There is more areas of ways to get involved. And so show up. And if anything, if for some reason you don't like the rally, there's also a really great farmers market that's going on too.
True.
A lot going on Saturday. Mm-hmm. Why should, Jessica, why should folks make the recovery rally part of their weekend?
You know, I guess thinking back, I used to be someone who was extremely lost and someone who, you know, and if that's I have a family member or myself as a person struggling with, you know, with an addiction. I just don't see the way out. I don't think there's hope. I don't think people actually do recover. I used to be one of those people. And then I found people who do recover. I found people who are living in recovery. And that's what this is about. And so I challenge you to come to the recovery rally in Madison so that you can see for yourself that recovery is possible, because going to be hundreds of people walking around living and breathing recovery every single day of their lives, and you will not be disappointed, because I know these people personally, and if it were not for these people, I don't know where I would be today. Because they continue every single day of my life. And so that's why you should come, because everyone needs a little hope in them.
Yeah.
Well, I'd like to thank you guys for coming on the program today and sharing your stories.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, thank you. I just want to take a moment to just highlight and take a moment to recognize the work that also goes into putting something like this together. Mm-hmm. I know that, or if anybody knows what it's like to host an event, it is not a simple thing to do. And to see so many resources and all the organizations and all the volunteers, I am so grateful for each and every one of them who are standing up, letting their name be known, coming to this rally, coming to the steps of the Capitol, but also to highlight the work, Jess, that you have done specifically as a person and as a leader and an advocate and a mother. You are doing a beautiful job, a phenomenal job. And I envy you, and I aspire, and I look up to you, and I am so incredibly grateful. And I speak not only for myself, but also for the thousands of people and lives that you have changed, not only here in your hometown and in your community, but also across the state and across the nation. And I just want to take a moment to highlight that, because
this conversation is not easy. And anybody that I know that has been affected by addiction, it's not easy to talk about. And the work that you do day in and day out, on top of raising beautiful children, running another nonprofit organization called Stop Heroin Now, and then also the incredible work that you do with Wisconsin Voices and pulling an event like this together. Guys, this is going to be the best recovery rally that we've ever seen. I'm so excited, and I can't wait to see you guys all there.
Thank you.
It's all on the steps of the state capitol this Saturday.
Yeah.
11 a.m. to 3 p.m.
Yeah.
Put a lot of work into this, Jessica.
I didn't do it alone. I have a great team.
I get the idea you're the committee chair of the for organizing this event. Yeah. A lot of work goes into something like this.
It does, yes.
Well, certainly our hats off to you, as Nadine said, and your entire committee and everybody who helps put something like this together. There will be a seventh recovery rally in Madison about this time next year.
Absolutely. It's every September.
Every September. Excellent. Will you come in before then even and catch us up on what Stop Heroin Now is doing, on what the Wisconsin Voices for Recovery is doing, and Rise Together? Will you keep us updated throughout the course of the year before this time next year? We'd love to be able to sit down with you guys again.
Yeah, absolutely.
Once again, Jesse Geschke is the program coordinator with Wisconsin Voices for Recovery. Nadine Miskovich, also with Wisconsin Voices for Recovery. She's an advisory council member, but is also the vice president of Rise Together, vice president of operations. The recovery rally, once again, it's this Saturday, State Capitol, 11 a.m. to 3 p.m. There's a wide variety of speakers, including Monte Ball, Ryan Hampton, a nationally known traveling speaker on recovery, formerly in the White House at one time, and is now working toward helping others deal with this affliction. From the Darius Rucker Band, Lee Turner is going to be performing. He's going to be speaking. Don't forget his wife is organizing that shoe drive, the shoe drop. And, you know, on Community Comment, we've had folks from Souls for Souls here many, many times over the years. It's a wonderful program. Bring a pair of shoes out there, and they'll have a T-shirt for the Voices for Recovery group for everybody that does bring that. You've got the quilts that are going to be out there, the Faces of Addiction quilts. There'll be Narcan training, food, speakers, all of that going on in one four-hour event. I want to thank you guys.
Good time.
Days and months to put together in 4 hours is a very important 4 hours that is going to be taking place at the Capitol this Saturday. Again, I want to thank you guys very much for sharing your story with me today.
Yeah, thank you.
That is going to do it for today's Community Comment.
If a new smile is what you're looking for, we have the answer for you. Hi, this is Dr. Adam Forster at Columbus Family Dental, where we specialize in making people smile. We promise to take the time to get to know you so we can provide you with a custom plan to help you achieve the smile of your dreams. Our experienced team looks forward to hearing from you soon. Call us today at 623-5559.
Come to Columbus Family Dental. The people here are nice, and I trust them.
Are you tired of getting hit with bowling balls every time you turn your water on due to the fact that it's so hard? Give us a call over at Schaefer's Soft Water in Watertown. We are a family-owned and operated business for over 60 years. We service and install and repair all major brands of water treatment equipment, both residential and commercial. So give us a call at Schaefer's Soft Water in Watertown at 920-261-3908 or 1-800-633-7440.
This Green and Gold Fix is brought to you by Kyle, the Dealmaker Bus at Countryside Auto Group in Beaver Dam. Kyle will save you time and money when buying a new or used car or truck. Call Kyle at 920-382-1990.
The Packers have to face a Vikings squad this weekend. They will look to run the ball more than in seasons past. Minnesota had a trio of running backs combined to carry the ball 32 times, while quarterback Kirk Cousins threw the ball just 10 times in their Week 1 victory over the Falcons. Packers linebacker Blake Martinez says it's a different Minnesota team as far as the run game is concerned than last year.
It's crazy to kind of see how they've switched since last year. I feel like last year they passed the ball a ton, did a lot of things in that aspect. But yeah, it's going to be, like I said, another tough test for us, especially front seven, to stop the run game and make sure we're on our P's and Q's in the fundamentals.
It's the Packers and Vikings Sunday at Lambeau Field. Kickoff is set for noon.
Kathy knows that for Vita Park Eye Associates, it's the team that makes the difference in patient care.
The people at Vita Park were wonderful. I mean, they're very professional, taking great care to do all the tests and the measurements correctly. The procedure was just as Dr. Wilkins explained it to me. The follow-up is great. The next day, they wanted to make sure I didn't have any pain, that I didn't have any infection. They made sure it was following the directions as far as the drops that I was using. Before I had the procedure, I could not read a book unless I took off my glasses and held it about 4 inches from my face. Now I can read a book. I can drive without glasses, which is wonderful. I would definitely recommend Vita Park Eye Associates. The procedure is something that you don't need to be afraid of. The results are amazing.
Learn more at VitaParkEye.com. Partially covered by Medicare, results may vary.
Westwood One presents NFL 100, remembering a century of excellence in pro football, sponsored by Prevagen. Prevagen is the most recommended memory support brand by pharmacists. Perhaps the toughest decision the NFL ever had to make was after the September 11th terrorist attacks in 2001. Weighing the balance between a nation's need to mourn and the disruption of American life, Commissioner Paul Tagliabue chose to cancel all games the following week. Giants defensive end Michael Strahan got a firsthand look at the devastation in New York City.
We are not heroes. The people who are over there pulling people out, those are heroes. We're guys who come out and just are very lucky to do what we do for a living. And those are the guys who put their lives on the line. That's a hero.
When the football heroes did return to the field a week later, security was heightened and patriotic fans bonded together as America began the long healing process. Stay with Westwood One all season long as we celebrate the 100th season of the National Football League.
Napa know-how. At Napa, save up to $10 on a pair of Rain-X Latitude wiper blades. Plus, get Rain-X glass cleaner for free. It's a deal so good, you gotta see it to believe it. That's a vision joke. And with up to $10 off Rain-X Latitude wipers plus free Rain-X glass cleaner, you'll be able to see almost everything. Quality parts, helpful people. That's Napa know-how. Napa know-how. At participating Napa Auto Parts stores, while supplies last. Offer ends 9/30/19.
Hi, my name's Christina Stumble, and I own Farm Girl Flowers in San Francisco. With my Spark Cash Card from Capital One, I earn unlimited 2% cash back on all my business purchases. Last year, I redeemed $115,000 in cash back. Yeah, $115,000. And that doubled our digital marketing budget for the summer. Thanks to my Spark Card, we had our best summer yet. Imagine what the Spark Card from Capital One could do for your business. What's in your wallet?
Real Capital One customers pay for real stories.
High-quality, compassionate primary care close to home is the cornerstone of your family's health and wellness. BDCH Medical Clinics in Beaver Dam, Columbus, Horicon, Juneau, and Waupun are here to support you along your personal journey of wellness. Experienced physicians and talented advanced practitioners work with you to prevent illness and disease and care for your health concerns. Learn more about BDCH Medical Clinics close to you. Visit bdch.com/clinics.com or call 920-887-7181.
Tune in to AM 1430 WBEV for coverage of the Milwaukee baseball game this Sunday and listen for the Columbus Family Dental Mystery Player of the Game. Listen to the WBEV Morning Show the following Monday and be the correct number caller when we ask who was the Columbus Family Dental Mystery Player of the Game. Get it right and you will win two tickets to a Milwaukee baseball game. Be sure to listen to WBEV this Sunday for the Milwaukee Baseball Mystery Player of the Game, brought to you by Columbus Family Dental.
Listen to WBEV online anytime at dailydodge.com. Brought to you by Beaver Dam Piggly Wiggly.
Here's a look at your weatherology forecast. Scattered thunderstorms likely this afternoon, otherwise cloudy. High temperatures reach up to 78, winds out of the southeast 8 to 15 miles per hour. Isolated thunderstorms likely tonight, lows level off around 60, overcast skies. Cloudy skies tomorrow, isolated thunderstorms likely, daytime highs approaching 75. I'm meteorologist Jennifer Wojcicki on your hometown station, AM 1430 WBEV. Currently, it's 77.
Love is but a song we sing.
fears that we would die. You can make the mountains ring or make the angels cry. Though the bird is on the wing and you may not know why. Come on, people now, smile on your brother, everybody get together. Some may go, he will surely pay his. When the one that left us here returns for us at last, we are but a moment's sunlight fading in the gray. Come on!